Today, we're going to talk about how to show both the account number and customer name in a pivot table. And I'm going to start off with a really bad twist here. This is data that came in, let's say, from the sales reps, and they fill in the account number and customer name, and they're not doing it consistently. So we have General Electric and GE, and it's just a real mess. If we try and create a pivot table from this data, insert pivot table, put it in an existing worksheet right here, click OK, and choose both account, customer, and then maybe revenue, something like that. You see that here in A128, it's spelled both ways, all right? So even if we come here to the design tab and say subtotals, do not show subtotals, it's ugly because AT&T is showing up in, you know, it's broken. Like really the total should be that and we're getting two rows. Okay, so first solution here is I rename the customer column as bad customer and then I insert a brand new column and the formula here says go look up D2 A128 in this red table here and return the first customer that you find. So customer is the second column, the zero means we want an exact match. You see what that does is it gets us both AT&T for both of these customer names. Anytime we have A128, it's going to have AT&T, and General Electric will be, you know, whatever happens to be first is what we're going to get in this column. But the advantage of that is when we insert the pivot table in an existing worksheet, we'll choose here, and I choose, let's say, account, and instead of bad customer, I choose customer, and then revenue. Now it's almost a simple fix. We come here to the design tab, subtotals, do not show subtotals. And we have a pivot table that shows us both account number and customer, and then sum of revenue. All right, so that's one cool solution. You know, I actually prefer getting both of these into a single column. So if you take a minute here, just take a look at this solution too. So bad customer, customer. Well, in this one, I take whatever's in D2, concatenate it with a space dash space, and then concatenate that with the VLOOKUP, the same VLOOKUP we used to fill the customer column. And that creates something called account customer. And you see that now in this pivot table, we just choose account customer for the row field, right? So we're taking care of it in the source data to try and clean it up a little bit. And now we see both the account number and the customer and the revenue. So I probably, if I had to do this over and over and over, I would use this method. If I had the extra time. This definitely is faster. It's just potentially you're gonna run into problems later if you have both account and customer in there. Let's say we wanted to add product in and we want subtotals on product. See, then we have to come back in, subtotals, show subtotals at the bottom of the group. And now we're getting subtotals for both product and account. So there's certainly times where getting the account and customer together into a single column would be a faster and better solution. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.